Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Medical Educational Video by Dr. Wellness. My name is Dr. Chen Yiming, and I'm a family physician practicing in Singapore. Singapore has signed advance purchase agreements with Moderna and Pfizer-BioNTech and are in discussions with a few other companies to bring COVID-19 vaccines into the country. In fact, just on 14th December, Prime Minister Lee Hsien Loong has announced that COVID-19 vaccines will be made available free to all Singaporeans. Health Science Authority Singapore has authorized the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine for pandemic use in Singapore, and the first batch has already arrived. So today, I'll be sharing more about the Pfizer and Moderna COVID-19 vaccine. How does it work? Who should get this vaccine? And whether the vaccine is the solution for the COVID-19 pandemic. Before we begin, please click on the subscribe and notification button if you are new to my channel. This will allow you to receive updates whenever I produce a new video. If you would like to know more about the vaccines, how they are being produced, and why a long time is needed to produce a new vaccine, please click on the link on the top right of your screen now. Vaccines of the past usually contains a weakened or dead form of the virus or bacteria. By injecting the weakened or dead virus or bacteria into our body, it allows our immune system to recognize them and create immune cells to fight against them. And when we do come into contact with them in future, in a real infection, our immune system would recognize them immediately, and you can mount an attack to kill them and prevent a full-blown infection. The two new messenger RNA vaccines created by Pfizer-BioNTech and Moderna are novel and different from the traditional vaccines. These vaccines do not contain any COVID-19 virus. Instead, it contains a genetical code called a messenger RNA. Do you remember how the COVID-19 looked like? It's essentially a spear with protein spikes on its surface. Scientists have created the messenger RNA that codes for the protein spikes on the COVID-19 virus. The messenger RNA contained within the vaccine will travel and enter our body cells after it's injected into our muscle. Once inside our cells, the messenger RNA basically provides the instructional manual that allows our protein production factory within the cell to produce multiple copies of these spike proteins. When these spike proteins have been created and released, our immune system will now recognize these spikes and create antibodies against the spikes. So when we truly meet with the COVID-19 in future, our body would already have antibodies against the spikes of the COVID-19, and we will be able to mount an immune response to fight the COVID-19 virus and prevent an infection. The messenger RNA in the vaccine will then be destroyed within hours to days after its work is done. So how effective is it? Pfizer's vaccine has been studied in people 16 years old and above with a 95% effectiveness in preventing symptomatic COVID-19 infection from 7 days after the second dose of vaccine. Two doses of the vaccine injected 21 days apart are required. The vaccine from Moderna has been studied in people 18 years and above with 94% efficacy in preventing symptomatic COVID-19 infection from 14 days after the second dose of vaccine. Two doses are required 28 days apart. It's still not known whether if the vaccine prevents asymptomatic infection with COVID-19, but it is also not known if people vaccinated can transmit the virus to others. Common side effects are injection site pain, fatigue, headache, muscle and joint pain. Some people in the trials reported fever. About 14%, which is 1 in 7 of people, developed fever after receiving the vaccine. Another recent side effect that is of concern is allergy to the vaccine. Patients may get rash or eye swelling or even airway swelling due to the vaccine. Side effects are more common after the second dose. The vaccines have not been studied in children less than 16 years of age and pregnant ladies as of the time of production of this video. So the vaccines are not for people who fall into these two groups. And if you're breastfeeding, you should stop breastfeeding for 1 week. If you are trying to have a baby, you should defer the conception during the vaccination period and for at least 1 month after the second dose. Also, more studies will need to be done to evaluate how long the vaccines will last and whether there are any long-term side effects. So are these vaccines the solution for the pandemic? Well, the vaccine gives you a 95% protection, which means to say you still have a 5% chance of catching the COVID-19 infection. Secondly, there is still a possibility that you could be an asymptomatic carrier of the virus and transmit the virus to others despite receiving the vaccine. Hence, by receiving the vaccine, it does not guarantee that you don't catch the virus. But if everyone around you and you yourself receive the vaccine, then the risk of you actually catching the virus from them is very much reduced because you are 95% protected and everyone around you is 95% protected too. But that would take time as the vaccine is being produced and distributed worldwide. So in the meantime, there is still a need for mask wearing and social distancing for now to reduce your chance of catching the virus. Thank you for watching this video till the end. Again, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already done so. Like the video and share it with your friends and your loved ones if you found it beneficial. I hope that you have learned more about the novel COVID-19 vaccine and that you are ready for your vaccination. So play your part in stopping the pandemic. Have a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Till the next time, stay safe, stay healthy.